Today's video, I'm gonna show y'all how to make a gorgeous, healthy, delicious, perfect, healthy, healthy, yummy, 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 quinoa stuffed acorn squash. You're gonna die. It's so good.
Eat it, all of it, yum.
Hey guys, it's Elizabeth, and today on Broke But Skinny, cooking tips for chicks on a budget who wanna eat like royals, wanna live like royals, be royals. They want to eat like Henry VIII, but look like Kate Middleton. Love the hats, Kate. I sincerely do. I really do. I love them. I think, like, they're great. Anyway, it's me, the crazy quinoa lady, and today we are going to make a delicious, healthy quinoa stuffed acorn squash. You are gonna love it. It is so good. This would make for a perfect dish on its own, like an entree. You could just serve it with maybe a salad or a crisp glass of wine and it's done. Otherwise, it makes for a really amazing, show-stopping, fantastic, standout, memorable side dish for your dinner party or holiday table. This is something you should consider making because it's so good. Now, I'm not so much of a meat eater. I don't hate on anyone who is. I got a lot of friends who are, and I'm always trying to amp up my vegetarian dishes so that I can manipulate their palates and bring them into my clutches, to bring them into my healthy tribe. Shout out to my herbivore cult members. Love you, love you, love you. Anyway, this dish makes that possible because it's so good. This makes 4 servings or more, and depending upon what you already have in your kitchen and in your pantry, this cost me somewhere between $4 to $7 to make, so not bad. As far as the ingredients go that we're using today, like, don't sweat it. You can add or remove really any of them, and I encourage you to do that. Express yourself, get creative, and you go on and color outside the lines if you want to. And if you do and you discover something fantastic, leave it in the comments and let us know. So anyway, these are the ingredients that I typically always have on hand. So this is what I'm making today. And I encourage you to give it a go and let me know how it works out. All right, let's get to it. This is an acorn squash, and this is what's so great about it. It's got a lot of vitamin A, vitamin C, it's full of antioxidants, and beta carotene. So it's really yummy, and it's really healthy, and it will keep you pretty. Great. When we have this, you can cut an acorn squash straight down the length like this, or you can cut it across the center. Personally, I think it looks prettier when you cut it across the middle like this, because then you have sort of a star shape on your plate and it's pretty. But the problem is that it rolls around on your plate and you end up having to cut off the bottom and sacrifice that or the top to just to keep it upright. So I go for just cutting it straight down the middle like this. That's what works for me, and I feel like I have more leverage when I do that. So cut it in half, scoop out the seeds, and then drizzle a little bit of olive oil on it so it doesn't stick. And we're gonna season it with salt and pepper, and that's it. And then we're gonna put it cut side down on a baking sheet, We're gonna put it cut side down on a baking sheet. I do it face down. Some people prefer it face up, to each his own. And then we're just gonna roast it until tender, about 30 to 45 minutes, depending upon the size of your particular acorn squash. No two acorn squashes are alike, in a 375 degree oven. Meanwhile, heat up a saute pan, add 1 chopped onion, or about 3/4 bag of frozen chopped onion, because that's what I'm gonna use. I'm all about what's easy. We're so easy over here. And then just cook it down until it starts to look a little translucent. And while that's happening, we are going to chop up some garlic. Are you ready to have your mind blown? I'm gonna blow your mind. The problem with chopping garlic is that it gets all over your knife and your cutting board, right? It's like sticky. The oils from the garlic just make a mess. But what would you say if I had a solution, huh? And no, it's not a garlic press. You're still just using your knife. Instead of putting salt into your recipe, we are going to put salt into the garlic. I got about 1/4 teaspoon of salt, and I'm putting it on my cutting board. And then I'm gonna chop the garlic into the salt. Now, the salt has absorbed all the oils, and you've made your own garlic salt. It doesn't stick to your knife, and it doesn't stick to the cutting board, and it sprinkles so nicely. You're welcome. So we're gonna add the chopped garlic to the onion and then add some mushrooms. I already chopped some up. This is gonna be all mixed together with the quinoa, so your mushrooms, they don't have to be chopped perfectly. And then we're gonna just turn the heat down so that the garlic doesn't burn, and let's get the mushrooms to cook down a bit. If you've got a lid, use it, it'll save you time. It'll only take like 5 minutes maybe. And if you tend to burn garlic, consider adding it after the mushrooms have started to cook down. And don't worry about it, there's no shame, everybody's done it. Just turn the temperature down, okay? You need to calm down and turn down the temperature. Now, because I'm a little crazy, last time I made this, I added some chopped habanero, and it was delicious. You could try that. Go for it. Jalapeno would also be really, really good. Unfortunately, I don't have that today, and I didn't feel like picking anything else up at the store. So I'm just gonna use a whole bunch of red pepper flakes because I love them, and that's what I got on hand. Even if your mouth is like a giant crybaby, I really encourage you to try to add a little bit of heat.
Even if it's just a little bit, a teeny, teeny pinch, a little bit of pepper, just a little.
Because it's gonna help tie all the flavors together. When you add a little bit of heat, you're gonna start tasting some of these other notes, and it just makes it so good. So just try a little. You can be conservative if you want, because you can always add more later, but add something. Just try it, I promise. And now I'm gonna throw in some spinach. Again, it's frozen. I got about 1.5 to 2 cups. Get it all wilted and yummy. If you're not feeling spinach, you don't have to add it. You can use kale or Swiss chard if you want, or nothing at all, it doesn't matter. I'm just in the mood for some spinach, so that's what I'm gonna put in it. Once everything's cooked, give or take 5 or 8 minutes, toss this into a mixing bowl. And I'm just gonna squeeze a little bit of lemon juice on here to help brighten everything up a bit. Again, optional, but I like it, so get some lemon. Worst case, you just stick it in your water. You're drinking water, right? You're drinking your water, right? Now grab some quinoa. I already have this made. I'm gonna use 1.5 to 2 cups cooked quinoa. Add some fresh black pepper and stir the quinoa and give it a good taste. You could be done now if you want, but if you wanna add some cheese, feta is what I'm gonna use. Otherwise, Parmesan is gorgeous. And if you use the habaneros, maybe consider some cotija cheese. Really good too. Just be mindful that there's a lot of salt in cheese, especially feta. So don't add any more salt until everything is incorporated and mixed up and you've had a chance to taste it. Worst case, you need to add more salt, and you can do that when you're eating it. So this is basically done, but it just still feels like something might be missing. So before I completely move forward, I'm just gonna toss in a couple chopped green onion, and I'm gonna add some chopped almonds. I just wanna give this a little bit more texture and bite. If you're counting calories, don't go nuts on the nuts, okay? Because I didn't go overboard on the garlic or the sauteed onion earlier, adding a little extra green onion won't overwhelm anyone. But honestly, I just wanna eat these before they go bad. The squash is donezo. Amazing, gorgeous. We could eat this just like this with nothing else. This would be divine. All right, so here we go. We're about to stuff some squash. We're gonna get our stuff on the squash. Stuff the squash, stuff the squash. So you could just add the filling now if you wanted, but I am gonna take it one step further and cheat again. I'm gonna scoop out a little bit of each squash so that there's more room for filling. And I'm gonna stir what I scooped out into the mixture. It's gonna help bind everything together so that when you take a bite, you're always gonna get a little bit of that acorn squash flavor. Try this, it's awesome. And you're gonna have a little bit more room for that delicious filling. So fill up the squash and then sprinkle it with a little bit of cheese if you want. Shout out to my vegan friends. And then put it under the broiler until it looks like it could be in a magazine. That is the technical term for how long it should be in there. And then sprinkle it with some parsley and done. Gorgeous, magnifique, squash stuffed gorgeous. We have made some sexy, sexy squash. Dude, if you've got extra filling, don't tell anyone. It's yours and yours alone. Eat it yourself, it's so good. You can eat it tomorrow for lunch, or you could maybe put it inside some little tortillas and make it tacos. It also makes for an amazing base to put inside enchiladas, like in vegetarian enchiladas, so good. There's a lot that you can do with this. You are welcome, it's delicious, yum, 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 yum. Thanks so much for watching, I really appreciate it, and I hope you make this. Let me know how it works out for you. And if you liked this recipe and you wanna see more of them, be sure to visit my channel. I've got a lot of other quinoa recipes, and if you're into squash, don't worry. I got more recipes on squash too. Hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please be sure to hit like and hit subscribe and that little bell so you don't miss any more of my content. And join the fun, join the party. Come make good food with us, and let's build this channel, let's grow it. Thank you.